Hey everybody, how's it going? Check it out. I got the Auto-Vox D6 Pro. This is a Wi-Fi dash cam. It's gesture enabled. I'm going to do a quick review and kind of get it all set up. And so if you're interested in something like this, you should definitely stick around.
Hey everybody, how you doing? If you like the video, hit subscribe. I appreciate it.
I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter.
All right, so let's take a second so we can see what's inside this box. All right, so first thing comes up with this, bam. Anyway, it's the warranty card. Look, it looks kind of like a car. And you can become part of the Amazon reviewer program. They sent this to me to test it out. I'm all right with that. Got a little user's manual right here. Kind of nice. There's all your instructions, including how to wire this thing up. It's very nice. There is a QR code right here that you can scan, I believe, to get the app. And this is a Wi-Fi dash cam. It says more than just recording. Yeah, well, I'll be the freaking judge of that. And this is a 1920 by 1080, 16 by 9 aspect ratio, 30 frames per second dash cam. Does have a pretty wide angle lens built into it. I believe it is 152 to 158 degrees wide. So that's pretty wide. So it covers, not wide enough to be fisheye and completely wreck your footage if you want, but just enough to sort of maybe put a slight rounding around the edges there. It does use a Panasonic CMOS sensor. Okay, which is pretty nice. Okay, so it was 152 degrees. So, and it's 1.8 for your aperture, f1.8, lets in a lot of light. So the more light, hopefully the better performance you'll have in low light conditions. And the Wi-Fi is 2.4 gigahertz, and that's 802.11 B, G, and N. And if you don't know what that means, that's okay, but it just means that it does cover quite a bit of Wi-Fi ranges, so your phone should be good to go. You could use a tablet if you want. It just has to be Wi-Fi, and you have to have the app installed. Because this does use an app. This uses an app to be able to let you control most of the camera, because when I show you in a camera in a second, you'll understand why you need the app. They recommend you use a Class 10 memory card up to about 64 gigabytes in the working conditions, say, basically minus 20 Celsius to 70 Celsius. Don't know. I'm not European. Don't care what that means exactly. Okay, so for video processing, it has 3D denoising, image enhancements. Also, a little correction there when it comes to your video. MP4 format. Very nice, has two channels. And this says lens, six glasses, 152 degrees wide. I guess they're trying to say that it has six lens elements built into it. But it is a Panasonic CMOS sensor, not CCD. Some people say it's CCD, but this is the Pro version, and I believe the Pro version does have the update where it has a faster processor and a better CMOS sensor built into it so that you can get better quality video. The reason why I haven't done any reviews on dash cams and things like that in the past is because honestly, I've never been happy with the video. And people will say, well, it's got all these features. At the end of the day, that crap doesn't matter. If your video sucks on your dash cam, it sucks. It should perform well in low light, and you should be able to read license plates and things like that. Because if you're using this dash cam as an actual dash cam and somebody hits you or you run into something, it's good to know what's going on, right, in the video. To be able to see it clearly, to get an idea of what's going on, to either protect yourself or document something, whatever it winds up being. I will say this, this Wi-Fi dash cam does not have GPS. So since it does not have GPS, it also means that your speed is not going to be recorded, and where that may be a plus for you or whatever. But you know, the weird thing is that it uses the app, and it uses an app because you have to have an app. So why couldn't they use the GPS off the phone to record it for, I don't know, you see what I'm saying? Because I mean, technically, if you're using a mobile device, your mobile device is GPS enabled, it should be able to record the GPS latitude, longitude when you're going down the road, especially if it's connected via the app. Anyway, uses a micro SD slot. Let's go ahead and pull this little camera out so you can kind of take a look at it. The box is very nice and it's well packaged. Look at this. Yes. Ooh, it's cylindrical shaped. Pretty cool, huh? This is supposed to be able to rotate, and it does. You get like 300 degree coverage, and it kind of goes in your car like this. And you also have the 3M sticky pad to stick it to your window. No suction cup, which is actually kind of cool, because I'll be honest with you, suction cups kind of suck when they fall off. Speaker on the back, that's kind of cool. There's where your micro SD card goes. I actually put one in there already. What is that? Is that a microphone? Nope, it's actually the reset button. And here's where you connect the power. Power is basically micro USB. I don't believe this thing has a battery in it. I think it uses a capacitor to be able to kind of let it record for a short period of time if you have it set for your parking lot monitor mode, which is pretty cool. And you have these little sensors on the bottom here. And this basically, so when you have it installed, if you need to take a picture, you can just swipe your hand like Kung Fu, yeah, like Fruit Ninja, and it'll capture a picture for you. Here's one thing I don't necessarily think it makes sense. I'm recording video. Why would I want to swipe my hand and take a picture? I don't know. My hope is, and I haven't explored this, my hope is that when I swipe my hand underneath it, it actually stops the video. So if something cool happens, like you see some of those Russian dash cam videos, like a meteor flying by, and you swipe your hand, it'll actually save that last video, because this will record over. It gets to the end, it loops, and records over. So if something happens, you need to make sure that you save your video. And it should be saved on that memory card, and also you can have it put over to your phone, because it uses an app. This little thing here needs to come off. So, sticky pad, right? Camera, rotates up to 300 degrees, sensors, speaker on this side, and has a reset with the trans flash or your memory card slot on the side. Power gets hooked up here. It should come with all sorts of cool stuff, and it does. An extra sticky pad, which is very nice. So if you make a mistake, you can stick it somewhere else, because this will be stuck to your window. Well, that being said, that may not be, you know, but you know, here's the thing. You can actually pull the mount off, so you can actually remove this off your windshield so it doesn't stay stuck all the time, because that would be a little bit of an aggravation there. Almost looks like you could do like a GoPro or something. So you can stick it where you want it, slide it back and forth, good to go, life is good. You don't want it hooked up there so somebody come by and pinch it or steal it, you just basically slide it off, put it away. This little bag of crap contains the other stuff that comes with it that makes it necessary to be used. This thing is like 12 feet long, between 10 and 12 feet long. This is your actual USB cable, so it's micro USB. It does have your standard USB in here, and it's pretty long, so hey, that's kind of nice. Because they give you enough room to be able to mount it and then actually run it along the top, you know, inside your car so you can hide the wires. Here's something that's actually pretty cool. It comes with a USB plug for your car, right? A little USB charger, which is very nice, but it does have two slots here. So even though it takes up one of your plugs, it is kind of low profile and everything, but you can actually charge two devices, and that's going to be 2.1 amps and 1 amp. Very nice. It feels kind of stupid. You'd probably pay like 10 bucks for this all by itself. Low profile though, so when it goes in there, it's pretty nice. I don't know if this lights up or anything like that. I don't really care so much. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a second and plug this in, see what's up. See, what I'm doing now is I'm actually doing like a bench test, bench review. I do have an external battery pack right here, and I'm going to use this to actually power up the camera and see what the camera looks like. Plugged in. I'll pull some of this cable out just enough. Because it would be kind of cool if the video is good enough and it uses the Panasonic CMOS sensor that I've seen in the past, the video should be really good, or at least really good for a dash cam. And my thought is that maybe there's a possibility of using this dash cam as a regular camera, because not only would it be cool to be able to record video and audio in your car as you're going down the road, because it does have 152 degrees of coverage, it might work out pretty good. So I don't know, we're going to kind of see. So I got the camera here, I'm going to go ahead and plug it in. You know, USB is, you plug it in, flip it, plug it in. Supposed to be some lights. Ooh, there's red. All right, so let me set this down for a second. Well, that was pleasant. All right, so the app you can download, it has iOS and Android versions of the app, so that you can kind of use that to determine which one you need to download. And once you have the app installed, you should be able to take and connect to the Auto-Vox using the app. So let me hit connect and see what happens here. All right, so here we go. Auto-Vox is listed in there. I don't know if you can see that or not. Auto-Vox D6 Pro Connect. Also have my Roku and everything else in there. And I believe the password is 1234567 8. 1234567 8. Let's see. Might be right, might not. Can you guys see that? Let's see what happens. Connect. Pending IP address, all the good stuff. And connected, no internet. That was actually pretty easy. So what? I'm in the setup section here. And there's some things you can change. You can set your speed units. So if you want to go miles per hour versus kilometers, you can do that. It does have the frequently asked questions. So the app looks pretty nice so far. I kind of like it. About us, frequently bought together, after sale service, and note. So pretty much that's all the choices I have at this point is to be able to set my speed. I could do kilometers and make myself feel like I'm going really fast, but I don't really care about that so much. So we can click on car cam, read the help. Don't want to read the help, how to connect, red LED is flashing, light is good. Whoa, I just took a picture. What? Taking another one. Remember the sensor up here? You want some of this? Yeah. So you can go. All right. Normally you'd have it mounted like this. So this would be on the screen. And then you can have the camera rotated whichever way you want. The sensor is going to be on the bottom. Now here's the deal. This thing is really sensitive so far, so you might want to change that. Because I'm assuming that shadows and things like that are going to set it up. You have the red light on the back though. Kind of let you know if you're connected or not. Blinking is good. It's capturing some images. Now, here's something to be aware of. You have the red light, right? When you have a red light and a green light, that means you're connected. And evidently, I'm not connected. So this would be the way you'd use the dash cam if you're not connected. You pretty much have it plugged in. As soon as you plug it in, it's going to turn on. Red means it's doing something and it's going to start basically doing its thing. So you're going to start recording video and you can capture images by waving your hand underneath it. So I think I need to go ahead and connect. Okay, once you are connected, the app will basically show you a picture of your device and then you hit open car cam. So you have your settings there, you hit the gear just like you normally would for your settings. Stop it. Kind of come in there like this. And let me see, D6 Pro voice prompt. You can turn voice prompts on or off. So you have it for your GPS. It's funny, it says voice prompt, GPS, collision taking pictures, gesture photography, phone photography, parking. So I'm gonna turn off parking and I'm gonna leave GPS. Collision taking pictures on. Now gesture photography, I'm gonna go ahead and click on that because I want that to be not so sensitive. So let me do this here. Voice prompt, mobile phone verification, sure. Short video, all right. First 10 seconds, first 5 seconds, last, okay, so I got that. Hardware decoding, okay. Parking lot surveillance, sound recording. There's a couple cool things you can do. The speaker does work. Listen.
Synchronize system time success.
Synchronize system time success. So this will actually synchronize with your phone, so you don't have to worry about date and time. You can adjust everything in here, speed units. You can manage the card. You can check the versions. You can do conflict sensitivity. You can set it all off. You can change it. You can make it low, medium, high. Really, there's a bunch of features involved here. If you don't want to go through and do all that stuff, all you have to do is basically plug it in and it does its thing. And then if you want to get the videos off of here, you can use your computer or whatever. You can take the memory card out and use a card reader, or you could actually just use the app. See which ones you want to download and download the video straight to your phone. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and install this in the van and give it a dry run. So I'm going to try to record, you know, going down the road and see how traffic looks. It does have a built-in microphone and it does have a built-in speaker, which is kind of nice. I did adjust the sensitivity of the gesture photography. See that? I adjusted it to where you really got to make it take a picture. Because it was just annoying. If the sensitivity is high, man, any kind of shadow, anything like that, it's going to try to take a picture. This way, you almost have to touch it. So, which is not a big deal, but it may be something to consider if you want to use that feature and you have a really big vehicle and you might have a hard time reaching where it needs to be. But I'm not too worried about it. So, stop it already. Oh, and you can basically turn sound recording on or off. So you can have your audio being recorded or not being recorded. It's pretty much up to you. Cool. All right.
peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I